What's up, guys? This is Nico from Limitless, and today we will take a look at the new set, because just a couple of hours ago, as you can see up in the top, 10 hours ago, Pokobeach released the full set list for Celestial Storm. Before that, we didn't really know 100% what was going to be in the set, what's going to be in the the Dragon Majesty mini set. But now we know which cards we are getting for Worlds, so I decided to just take a look at the set. I personally most cards I know are only the ones that are super in hype, that everyone's talking about. So but I will go over every card in the set, every uncommon, common, basic, whatever. So this might take some time, but yeah, let's get right into it without even wasting time. So yeah, I mean, first of all, we have. Let's take a look at everything. I mean, we have Bellsprout, 60 HP, basic Pokemon, grass, colorless, 20 damage, heal 10 from this Pokemon. This is just random common. Weeping Bell evolves from Bellsprout, obviously. Colorless Growth, attach up to 2 grass energies from your hand to this Pokemon. And double Razor Leaf, 30 damage, flip 2 coins, this damage does 30 damage times the number of heads for 2 energies. Also pretty bad. But let's see if Victory Bell is any good. So we have the ability Fragrance Trap. Once during your turn, before you attack, you may flip a coin. If heads, choose one of your opponent's benched Pokemon and switch it with your opponent's active Pokemon. If this was basic, or maybe even a stage 1, this card would be pretty good, because you could just save your Guzmas and stuff, as long, obviously, as the Pokemon you want to have active is active. But being a stage 2 and having to flip as well just makes it super inconsistent and hard to fit in any deck that doesn't already use a different Victory Bell, or uses this Victory Bell specifically. So the ability is good, but on this given Pokemon it's pretty clunky. The attack is for 2 grass and 1 colorless, corrosive acid, 80 damage, flip a coin, affects your opponent's active Pokemon, is now burned. Yeah, once again, I mean, if you flip heads, so, I mean, the new burn rule makes burn more viable, or better, but that still only means you deal 100 damage, and this doesn't even 100% apply to weakness, because if you would hit for weakness, it would just be 180, because you deal 160 because of weakness, and then plus 20 for burn. So no, I really don't like this Victory Bell. The ability is good, but as I said, on a stage 2 without a good attack, doesn't make any sense to play. Next up we have Cypher, twin play, search your deck for up to 2 Cypher and play them on your bench, then shuffle your deck. The attack is good, but we will have to see if Scizor is any good. I know that there's Scizor in the Scizor GX, and I know that some people think the card is good, but I don't remember 100% what the card does. So I guess we will have to talk about Cypher again when we get to the Metal Pokemon. But as for now, second attack for 2 colorless, 20 damage, flip a coin, effects prevent all effects of attack, including damage, done to this Pokemon during opponent's next turn. Yeah, I mean, if you were going to play this Cypher, it's 100% going to be for the first attack, because Scizor's good, so we will see later if Scizor's any good. So next up, Spinarak. Stun poison, flip a coin, effects your opponent's Pokemon is now paralyzed and poisoned, and pierce for 2 colorless, 20 damage, pretty bad. And Ariados, for 1 colorless, reactive poison, 20 damage, plus 50 for each special condition. And for 1 grass, spider trap, your opponent's active Pokemon is now asleep and poisoned. Before applying this effect, you may choose one of your opponent's bench Pokemon and switch it with the active Pokemon. If you do, the new active Pokemon is now asleep and poisoned. For those that have been around a little longer, I mean even longer than I've been playing, or just know about old decks, this is a reprint from an Ariados that was very good in 2006, I believe, or 2005, 2007, like somewhere in between. I don't know the exact date, but I know it was a good deck with Flareon EX combined. Yeah, but the problem is that because this is basically the same card, I mean, I think they adjusted the damage a little bit, so that's at least a little bit better in the current metagame. But being 70 HP and dealing 120 max with your first attack, it's just not good. It's a nice gimmick that they reprint a card that was good before, but this card just isn't good. Next up, Treecko from grass. Sleep poison, your opponent's active Pokemon is now sleep and poisoned. Yeah, whatever. The attack is good, or technically good, because sleep and poison is basically hypnotoxic laser and without a flip, and the card was super annoying. But yeah, it's a grass energy, so you have to play it in a grass deck, and it's also a 50 HP basic, so you probably don't want to play it on its own. But the deck is pretty neat. Yeah, and then the second Treecko has 20 HP more, has 70 HP, does 10 damage with smack, and grass colorless tail whip 20 damage. I mean, the difference between them is just going to be, if Skeptile is any good, do you want to risk having basically the same you have with Rockruff now, but just with even less HP? I mean, a lot of people still play the corner Rockruff, for example, in Zoroark Lycanroc. So this would, for example, be the same as the Treecko, lower HP, but a pretty good attack. And the other one is just the safe Treecko, for example, if you want to attach a grass turn 1 and don't want to have it Guzma KO'd by Lele with DCE, then you would play the other one. But yeah, let's go further if it makes even any difference, because if Skeptile is bad, then all of this is just for nothing anyways. Grovyle in between has Grass, Leaf Blade, 20 damage, Flip a Coin. If that's, this does 40 more damage, yeah, whatever, it's just random stage 1. And now we have Skeptile. Nature Power, each of your Pokemon with grass energy attached to it receives no damage from attacks from your opponent's Ultra Beasts. Interesting, but there aren't, aside from Beast Box, there aren't any decks that only use Ultra Beasts. But, I mean, in theory, this card is pretty good against Buzzrock, because they would have to use Lycanroc. And Lycanroc obviously is weak to grass, and they can't damage your Pokemon with grass energies. So this might actually be potential for like fun deck for this format. And for one grass, powerful storm damage, this attack does 20 times the number of energy attached to your Pokemon in play. So if you have 5 energies in play, you can just one-shot the Lycanroc. So, I mean, it's pretty okay. But it's still a stage 2, and against anything that's not Buzzrock, for example, how does this deck ever beat Zoroark? You still take the full amount of damage, you can't even get close to a one-shot very quickly, and I mean, if you want to have a one-shot, you will have to like 9 energies in play and then Choice Wand, so yeah, I mean, it's nice if you expect a lot of Buzzrock, for example, but other than that, it's more like a fun card. C-Dot, hang down, 10 damage, okay. Harden during your opponent's next turn. If this Pokemon would be damaged by an attack, prevent that attack damage done to this Pokemon if that is 40 or less. This is just super horrible, especially because it's only 40 HP. Next, C-Dot does, for 2 colorless, 30 damage, has 20 HP more. And Nuzleaf, for 1 grass, pound 20 damage, and for 2 colorless, your opponent reveals the hand, shows the supporter you find there, and your opponent shuffles into the deck. The attack is unique, and if the card would have like, let's say, ability like Hooper, for example, can't get damaged by GX and EX, or anything else, as an ability or as a like mean of stalling, you could very well build a mill deck or something similar with this card. But since it's just a stage 1 that shuffles a supporter card from your opponent into their deck, that's just too weak. But maybe Shifty Jax is good. So Shifty Jax does for 1 grass, 40 damage, your opponent's active Pokemon is now confused. It's basically Sylveon, Espeon GX for grass instead of psychic and 10 more damage. And then second attack for grass, Kaios, Kaios, extra sensory, 90 damage. This attack does 90 more damage if your opponent and you have the same number of cards in hand. So you basically have a attack that's super situational because, or like, not like super situational with cards like Judge and Copycat, but situational, and only if you can get to this exact situation you deal 180, could be to 10 of course. It's okay, the card is okay, let's not hate on to it too much, but I think it's I think it just lacks the synergy in the format, because I mean, of course, if there would be grass energy acceleration that's not Venusaur, then this card could have potential, but now you would have to attach two energies to it, and I mean, of course, there's 240 HP, so I guess it's not too bad. I mean, there are definitely worse cards in the set, but it's Shifty is definitely not like one of my top picks for this deck, but yeah, let's take a look at the Jax deck. It's shuffle one of your opponent's Pokemon and call all cards attached to it into the deck, also for grass colorless colors. I mean, that's basically okay, it's not basically, I mean, it's pretty close to Tapu Fini, with the difference, I mean, I don't know if it's a translation error or if it's actually true, but yeah, as you can see, it doesn't have the extra sentence of you can't use this GX attack if your opponent has only one Pokemon in play. So technically, if this isn't a translation error, you can just use Shiftry's GX attack if your opponent has one Pokemon in play, you shuffle it back and you win. But yeah, how do you get to this spot? I mean, I don't like it too much. I know that there are a lot of people that, or not a lot of people, I know there are people that like this card, but I think it's too slow for the current format and also too situational. I mean, if the second attack would be, I don't know how it would change. I think I would completely remove the second attack and give it a completely new one, because let's say you would change it to only one grass and then say like it does 40 damage plus 90, for example, if your opponent and you have the same amount of cards in hand. But then again, this card would be too weak, so you kind of need the one-shot attack for the card to be fully like playable. But it's also like a one-shot attack that needs too much energies in a format without energy acceleration for this given type. So yeah, I mean, let's just move on. I think the card has potential, sure, depending on which cards they release and how the meta game evolves, but as for now, I don't think so. Surskit, Bubble, flip a coin, fetch your opponent's active Pokemon is not paralyzed. Yeah, we know Bubble, we know Froakie, so yeah, it's just an attack for Pokemon that you want to protect. Now Masquerain, I've already seen this card, it's just one grass, surprise pattern, discard all special energies attached to your opponent's Pokemon in play. This is actually super interesting, because let's say your opponent has two strongs in play, for example, you can just discard them. On the other hand, the problem is that, first of all, you have cards like Enhanced Hammer, that, and I personally always see it like this, if there's an item that basically does the job better as a Pokemon, then there's no reason to play the Pokemon, because for example, back then when Pokemon Catcher was a thing, you didn't even play Pokemon with an ability to switch because you had Catcher. But Masquerain needs to attack to discard special energies in play. And Enhanced Hammer is just an item and you still get to attack. So, and Masquerain, let's take a look at the second attack, is for 3 colorless, 40 damage, flip 4 coins, this attack does 40 damage times the number of heads. I mean, the card is just bad. The first attack is a nice gimmick, but it doesn't deal any damage. So you lose a turn, and even if you don't lose your Masquerain, which is very likely, you have an attack that needs 3 colorless on a 90 HP stage 1, and you have to flip 4 coins, so let's just move on. Pheromone Catcher, 20 damage, if any of your Illumise use Pheromone Scent during your last turn, this attack does 100 damage. I already know where this is going. Then Illumis is one grass, pheromone sign, 20 damage, your opponent's active opponent is now confused. I mean, 270 HP basics, situational attack that requires you to use a different attack, a bad attack the turn before. So, in theory, Volbeat's attack would have to make up for two turns, because Illumis' attack is not very good, and it by far doesn't, unless you're playing a pre-release, so yeah, just bad. Next up, Cacnea. Ability Poison Payback. If this Pokemon is your active Pokemon, it's damaged by an attack, even if it's knocked out. The attacking Pokemon is not poisoned. And Light Punch, 10 damage. I mean, the wording shouldn't be if this Pokemon is your active Pokemon, damaged by, even if this is knocked out. It should just be your Pokemon is knocked out anyways. Because, I mean, it has 60 HP, so this won't really come in effect. So let's just take a look at Cacturn, because, I mean, Cacnea on its own doesn't do anything. Ability Poison Payback. If this Pokemon is your active Pokemon is damaged by an attack, the active Pokemon is not poisoned. The attacking Pokemon is not poisoned. So, yeah, exactly the same. And the attack is Fiend Attack. Choose one of your opponent's Pokemon. This attack does 50 damage to that Pokemon. This attack's damage isn't affected by weakness, resistance, or any effects of the Pokemon. I mean, do I even have to talk about the card? It's a 110 HP, stage 1. Same attack as a basic. Same ability as a basic, which is a bad ability on a Pokemon that gets one shot anyways. And it needs 3 colorless energies to deal 50 damage. No. Tropius, grass, 110 HP. Grass, find a friend, search your deck for up to Pokemon, reveal them, put them into your hand, then shuffle your deck. Solar Beam, 70 damage. I mean, same story basically. As Masquerain, for example, you have, even after rotation, you have Pokemon Fan Club. Even if it's a supporter, I'd rather use the supporter of the turn, which you want to use anyways, to get 2 Pokemon, instead of having to use an attack where I can't even put the basics down immediately. Because, I mean, let's say I use Find a Friend, grab the Pokemon, and I get judged or end, then I lose my attack. If it would put them on the bench, it would actually be a very good card in grass decks, because it's a very bulky basic. But as now, another just pre-release only card. Dalmise, I think, if I'm not mistaken, it's the first grass Dalmise we're getting, right? I mean, it's also the second Dalmise, I think. Or do we have other ones? I only know about the one that boosts metal and psychic attacks, but yeah. Giga Drain, 30 damage for 2 energies, heal from this Pokemon the same amount of damage you did to your opponent's active Pokemon, and grass, colorless, powerful spin with 30 damage, this Pokemon can't detect you in your next turn. It's also a bad card, unless you get cards to boost this attack to like 100 damage, and then you just go completely insane, attach for example, like bodybuilding, no, that doesn't even work. Fighting Fury Belt, and then just deal damage and heal, and it just doesn't get KO'd, but it will get KO'd, so it doesn't even matter. Next up, Slugma, Magma Ring, 10 damage to defending Pokemon contribute to your opponent's next turn, and Fire, colorless, 20 damage. Just the basic, but now we get to one of the nice cards. We have Makargo, with the ability Smooth Over. Once during your turn, you may search your deck for a card, shuffle your deck, and then place that card on top. I mean, as someone who played a lot of Zoroark this season, this card makes me pretty happy, because especially after rotation, Zoroark would lose a lot of cards, a lot of its power, stuff like Puzzle of Time, and also Bridget. But now we have a nice addition, especially because Parallel City rotates. We have Makargo, which basically is Mellow without having to use a supporter card. So yeah, this is like one of my favorite cards from the set, so far at least. Yeah, I like the card. I think it's very good. Next up, we have Torchic for 1 Fire Energy Pack, 10 damage. For 2 energies, 20 damage. It's just another random basic. Also, keep in mind, this is a translation error because this card clearly has 50 HP. Yeah, fire 70 HP, a different Torchic. Amber, 30 damage, discard 1 energy from this Pokemon. Also, I mean, if the evolution is not good, this card is not good. Combusken. Also, this is also another translation error. It's also 80 HP, not 70. Guys, you're sleeping. For two colorless, double kick, flip two coins, it takes 30 damage, tap the normal fats. Flamethrower, 3 energies, 80 damage, discard 1 energy from this Pokemon. Yeah. Random basic, as I said, for the other two. Or not basic, but in this case, random stage 1. Blaziken GX. Also 240 HP, so they're throwing around quite some numbers here with their GXs. But to be fair, they're all stage 2, so it makes sense. Yeah, for 2 colorless, slash 60 damage. Okay. Then for 2 fire and 1 colorless, explosive kick, 210 damage. Discard 2 fire energy from this Pokemon. And GX tick, blaze out GX, discard 2 energies from your opponent's Pokemon. So, my problem with this card is, I mean, the first tech is okay. I mean, it's just 60 damage for a DCE. But then we get to, like, the first part is, this would only be good if you could actually, not good, like, usable, if you could attach DCE to the Pokemon. But since the second attack is fire anyways, you would have to attach 2 fire to the Pokemon anyways. And you can't even discard a DCE because you have to discard 2 fire energy for the attack. I mean, the damage, of course, is super good. It's 210 damage. It knocks out basically everything. I mean, the GX attack is what bothers me most. Because your first the Pokemon just looks incomplete to me. You have an attack that deals random damage with an energy cost you can't really utilize with DCE. Then you have a second attack, which, in my mind, is the main part for the Pokemon. The second attack is just the powerful attack, because this is what you're going to use most of the time if you build your deck around the card. And so this makes sense. You discard 2 fire energy, you deal 210 damage. So it would come to mind you just play a super aggressive fire deck with energy acceleration, damage boosters, consistency and stuff. But then, to top it off, that your first attack doesn't make any sense. You have a GX attack that makes you discard 2 energy from your opponent's Pokemon. Why does a super aggressive Pokemon have a utility GX attack? I don't understand, because if I play aggressive deck, why would I want to use Disruption? I mean, of course I could, like, the only use that comes to my mind that makes sense in this scenario would be, okay, I use my second attack, discard 2 fire energies, then my opponent attacks me, whatever, and I attach another energy, because I'm a bulky GX Pokemon, and then I use my GX attack to prevent my opponent from KOing my Blaziken. But most of the time, your opponent has, I mean, if it's a two-shot, your opponent most of the time has an attacker anyways that is able to deal with your Blaziken that's already damaged. Or worst case, if you play something like Max Potion, you don't even get the benefit, because you play Max Potion, you attach your fire energy, you discard 2 energies, and then you get attacked immediately anyways, then you attach another energy, deal 60 damage to your opponent, you get attacked again, and then you can use your attack again. So I really dislike the GX attack. I think the card would have had so much more potential if they would give it a different GX attack. So yeah, I don't think the card is that good, because just another glass can that deals 210 damage, but we have basics that deal 210 damage and even have energy acceleration. For example, Duskmane Necrozma. You can play Solgaleo, and you could even play Metagross, because if you want to play a stage 2 deck, you might as well play a stage 2 deck with energy acceleration. So yeah. Blaziken also. Another GX that's pretty bad. I know that some people think it's good, but I think it's not. Yeah, Torkoal, 120, Burning Guidance, 30 damage, discard the top 4 cards of your deck. If any fire energy you were discard in this way, attach them to your Pokemon in any way you like. Searing Flame, 80 damage, your opponent's active form is not burned. Just a random, rare, common, whatever. It's just bad. I mean, if it would have at least have, like, for example, let's say Burning Guidance does 30 damage, you discard 4 cards from your deck, but you get to attach any fire energy from your discard to Pokemon, but you have to discard fire energies, so No, it's just more ING max elixir. With a bad side effect. Oricorio? Oricorio number 100 whatever. I mean, we have so many Oricorios already. Alluring Salsas, which one of your opponent's Pokemon with the active Pokemon, the new active Pokemon is now burned and confused. Heat Blast, 70 damage. No. Another bad card. So next GX is gonna be Articuno GX. Legendary Ascent. Once during your turn, when you play this Pokemon from your hand to your bench, you may switch your active Pokemon with this Pokemon. If you do, you may also move any number of water energy from your Pokemon to this Pokemon. So this is basically Tapu Koko GX. Same ability. First attack is for Water Water Colorless, 130 damage. If I'm not mistaken, Tapu Koko has the same. It also does 130 for 2 Water and a Colorless. So far it is basically the same card. But keep in mind that Water actually has Aqua Patch, so you have more reliable acceleration. So based on this, this card already, in my opinion, has more potential to be a good card. Also, Metal Weakness is not like the worst, because the only relevant Metal Attacker that's around now does 220 anyways, so you can't out anyways, even without Weakness. But yeah, the GX attacks Cold Crush. This got all energy from both active Pokemon. This is the same as Blazing. Like, I take a look at the first two parts of the card, like ability and first attack, I think this card might have potential, and then they hit you with a GX attack that's horrible and doesn't make any sense. Like, why would I want to discard all my opponent's Pokemon? I want, like, the only reason that Tapu Koko is decent is because you also have a very good GX attack. You don't max out at 130 damage. You can use Tapu Koko, and Tapu Koko is not even good, keep that in mind, at least for now. You use your ability and you can at least punish decks with a lot of energies in play, but this attack just discards your opponent's energy. Like, what? This doesn't make any sense, no. I'd much rather have a GX deck that actually KOs my opponent's Pokemon, because let's think about it. Let's think about what kind of GX attacks we have. We have Gardevoir GX. Shuffle 10 cards back in your deck. We had Decidueye GX. Take 3 cards from your discard but put them in your hand. We have Duskmane Necrozma. Deal 250 damage if you're behind in prizes. Dawnwings Necrozma. 180 damage, you don't get damage next turn. I mean, of course we had Disruption GX attacks earlier, but they were never really used. Because, for example, Umbreon GX had an attack that let you discard 2 energies. But if I'm not mistaken, they were actually like anywhere on the board. And now we have like Blazing that randomly discards 2 energies. Now we have Articuno that spends your GX attack. I mean, you even have to discard your own energies as well. I mean, of course, it only costs 1 energy, so you usually discard 1 energy. But still, you have a side effect on an attack that's not even good. No. I think the card had potential at the first two parts, but the GX attack just completely killed it. Yeah, so next card, Mudkip. Gather water, search your deck for up to 3 water energies, reveal them and put them into your hand, then shuffle your deck. Okay. Next Mudkip, for 1 water energy tackle, 10 damage. For water colorless, wave splash, 20 damage. Yeah, just another basic. Marsh Storm, Muddy Water, 20 damage. This attack does 20 damage to one of your opponent's bench Pokemon. Random stage 1. Second attack, 3 energy, 70 damage, and still random stage 1. So now it's gonna be for Swampert to, yeah, make something good. Ability Power Draw. Once during your turn, you may discard a card from your hand, then draw 3 cards. So basically, trade for 3, which is pretty nice. And the attack is for 3 colorless, 80 damage. This attack does 20 damage for each 1 energy attached to this Pokemon. There would be one part that would make the second attack so much more interesting, and that would be if it would, it could even be like 2 water and a colorless, for example, as an attack cost. But if the attack would say, this attack does 80 damage plus 20 for each water energy in your discard pile, because then you would actually have synergy. You would have Mudkip. You could even have synergy with your basic because Mudkip searches water energies. Then you can discard water energies with Ultra Ball and even the ability. And then you boost your damage. And then you ideally would have a second water attacker that, I mean, if I'm not mistaken, there is actually something like a Kingdra. There was a Kingdra back in the days, but I think there's another Kingdra, or at least something similar, that lets you deal damage based on how many energies are in your discard pile, and then you shuffle them all back in. So this would be a nice synergy, but as for now, I don't think this card is going to be played for the tech. But if you get a deck that consistently gets out stage 2s anyways, or maybe even expanded with Archies, the ability is definitely very good. So next up, Lotad. For one water, surprise, 10 damage, choose a random card from your opponent's hand without looking, your opponent reveals the card and then shuffles it into your deck. Just random. L'Ombre, water, stage 1. Aqualift, if this Pokemon has any water energy attached to it, retreat causes 0. Okay. And colorless, ambush, 20 damage, flip a coin effect, this attack does 20 more damage. Yeah, random stage 1. And Ludicolo is stage 2, evolved from L'Ombre. Ability, Swing Dance, once during your turn you may draw a card. It's okay, but it's a stage 2, so not too good. And for water, colorless, circular steps, 70 damage, this attack does 10 more damage for each Pokemon in play. I mean, the attack is okay, but the energy cost is very high. I mean, you max out at 190 if your opponent plays into your attack and you have a full bench as well. I mean, it definitely has potential, especially because of Aqua Patch, so I'm not gonna say the card is bad, because it definitely has potential. Wailmer. For 3 water, swallow waves, 5 damage. 50 damage. Flip a coin until you get tails. For each head, heal 50 damage from this Pokemon. Yeah, this is just bad. And then Wailord. For 4 water energies, dwindling waves, 200 minus damage. This attack does 40 less damage for each damage counter to this Pokemon. No. If you had consistent energy acceleration, that's not like 2 aqua patches or 3 aqua patches a game, whatever, then this card would have potential because you can actually deal 230 with Choice Band and if you're able to heal always. But I mean, the problem is that it's actually minus 40 damage for each. Like, let's say you get hit for 20, random 20 from a basic, you already deal minus 80 damage. So yeah, I mean, it's a fun card, but not too good. Then Klempel. Ability, evolutionary advantage. If you go second, this Pokemon can evolve during your first turn. Pretty interesting. And for one water, Sparkling Pearl, 10 damage. Yeah, random attack. Then Huntail, first evolution from Klempel, is for one water, Big Bite, 30 damage. The defending Pokemon can't retreat during your opponent's next turn. And for one water, two colorless, Dangerous Bite, 40 plus damage. If your opponent's active Pokemon is a base Pokemon, this does 80 more damage. I think the energy costs for the second deck are too high for the card to be viable, because of course 120 on a non-EX is pretty okay, but 110 HP, heavy energy cost, don't like it too much. Maybe Gorbis is better. Gorbis also evolves from Klempel. One water, Pink Spray, 30 damage, prevent all damage done to this Pokemon by evolution Pokemon to your opponent's next turn. The problem with this kind of attack is Tapu Lele. It's always going to be Tapu Lele, because even you can't build a good stall deck with this kind of attack, because Tapu Lele just is in every deck and can still attack through it. So even if you attack with this attack against a Zoroark deck that only plays like stage ones, they still have Lele and something. Buzzrock has basics anyway, so yeah. So I think that's going to be it for Klempel, because yeah, its evolutions are not that good. I don't know if I'm forgetting any Huntails or Gorbis that are in the format right now. Maybe they are good, but I don't think so. So we have Luftisk next. For one colorless even game, search your deck for a number of basic Pokemon up to the number of your opponent's bench Pokemon and play them on your bench, then shuffle your deck. That's interesting. If you go second and your opponent puts on a lot of basic Pokemon, but then again, an attack on an already weak Pokemon that has to rely on your opponent doing something. Don't like it too much. And then for two colorless water pulse, 20 damage, your opponent's active Pokemon is now asleep. It's just another random card. So now we have Regice, ability Ice Barrier. If this Pokemon is your active Pokemon, your opponent can't play any stadium cards from your hand. This card would be so good if it wouldn't say it has to be active. If this card would would also work on the bench, it would be so strong, because you would just put it on your bench, your opponent can't play any stadiums. Just like the Ninetales that was around some formats ago that said your opponent can't play any stadium. So yeah, but since Regis has to be active, the attack has to be good. It's 2 water, 2 colorless, icy wind, 60 damage, your opponent's active opponent's not asleep. Oh, that's sadly not a good attack. This card had actually a lot of potential up until it said it has to be active. Sad, because this would actually be a pretty interesting card. Next up, Kyogre. 1 water, colorless, dual splash, this attack does 30 damage to 2 of your opponent's Pokemon. Okay, and 2 water, 1 colorless, Grand Wave, 120 damage. This Pokemon can't use Grand Wave during your next turn. Yeah, this is just random card to get people hyped about a legendary Pokemon. Voltorb is next, ability Floating Electrons. As long as this Pokemon has any energy attached to it, the retreat cost is 0. And Lightning Colorless, Thundershock, 20 damage, flip a coin, if it's your opponent's Pokemon is now paralyzed. It's bad. Maybe Electrode is any better, and spoiler alert, I know it is. ability Energy Bomber, once during your turn, you may discard this Pokemon and all cards attached to it. This counts as knocking out this Pokemon, so basically the same as the Evolution's Electrode. If you do, search your discard pile for 5 energy cards, attach them to your Pokemon any way you like, excluding Pokemon EX and Pokemon GX. This is another sad part, because the card also, basically like Regice, had a lot of potential at first, but then it said you can't attach to GX and EX. So, I mean, the card is still okay, because it has a lot of energy acceleration. You can, for example, with Rayquaza, you just attach it to non-EX or GX, and then Rayquaza still deals more damage. But it would be nice if the card would actually attach to GX and EX, so unfortunately it's weaker than it could have been, but it's still okay. And let's take a look at the attacks. Maybe that's actually something you can keep in mind. Lightning Colorless, Energy Ball, 50 damage. Okay, no. And GX attack, Lightning Colorless, Crush and Burn, 30 damage. You may discard as many energies as you like attached to your Pokemon in play. If you do, this attack does 50 damage for each energy. Yeah, I mean, what they want to tell you is that the synergy is you use Electrode and another Electrode gets stronger, but actually that's not what you want to do, because you don't want to use a GX attack that requires you to discard all of your energies after you already gave your opponents 2 prizes just to get them into play. I mean, of course, it could be used as a game finisher, but for this, you would have to attach 2 energies to an Electrode. So, I mean, of course, you can use your first Electrode, then attach 1 energy to a Voltorb, and then later on evolve, attach another one, GX attack. But I think that would make the deck way too clunky. So, yeah, I mean, the card is okay, but nothing too spectacular. Xinzhou, 10 damage for 1 colorless, and for 1 colorless and a lightning spark, 10 damage. The attack does 10 damage to 2 of your opponent's bench Pokemon. Yeah, it's just another bad basic. And Lantern, ability Energy Grounding. You can use this ability once. Each time one of your Pokemon is knocked out by damage from opponent's attack, choose a basic energy card attached to the knocked out Pokemon and move it to this Pokemon. So it's basically an XP share. That's not an XP share, but it's an XP share on a situation. Let's take a look at the attack first, before I get too judging. 2 lightning, 1 colorless, lightning strike, 70 damage. You may discard all lightning energies attached from this Pokemon. If you do, this attack does 70 more damage. Yeah, I mean, that's basically what I thought. I mean, the ability is okay. Would be good on a Pokemon that actually deals damage, because you have to discard all your energies and you only deal 140 for 3. I mean, of course, you may have to discard. You can also only deal 70, but why would you want to do that? So, what I would have wished for this Pokemon to be good is that energy grounding actually says that you can attach the energy to any Pokemon, because then it would actually be an XP share that's in play that can't be field lowered. And that would have been nice, but now it's an XP share for itself with a bad attack, so bad card. Let's just say that it is as it is. Electrike, basic Pokemon, for 1 lightning, 20 damage. Okay, it's just a random basic. Now we have Manectric. Ability Volt Start. If you go second, you may play this card face down from your hand during setup. And for 1 lightning, double charge for the damage, you may attach up to 2 basic energy cards from your hand to one of your bench Pokemon. I really like this card. I actually do, because... I mean, first of all, let me say what I like about the card. It's basically like Talonflame. You have a... You have a stage 1 in this case, not a stage 2, that you can put down as basic that helps you. Because, for example, let's say you play the Rayquaza deck. You can Ultra Ball away energies and then you attach them back with Manectric, because if you go second, you can put it face down. You deal 40 damage, attach energies in play, you have energies for your Ray. But the first problem I have is obviously it's very situational, because you have to have it in your starting hand. But it gets even more situational, because you actually have to go second as well. I mean, of course it could be like a way to balance out going second, because usually if you want to go first always, but even in a Rayquaza deck, for example, but now you actually have something to decrease your disadvantage of going second, because you actually have a very good Pokemon for your first turn. And also in Rayquaza, because you discard cards from your deck and stuff, you can just discard your Manectric, just like you did back in the days with Battle Compressor decks, or you just used Ultra Ball to discard Talonflame. You can now use Ultra Ball to discard Manectric, you can discard Manectric with Ray's ability. So the card definitely has potential in the Ray deck, and yeah, I think it's a very good card. Situational, but you get rewarded if you get into the situation, because there are a lot of cards. Even if the situation gets fulfilled, they're still bad. But this card is actually pretty good. Next up we have Plusle. For one card is everyone draw, shuffle your hand into your deck, then draw a number of cards equal to the number of bench Pokemon. That's actually pretty good, because you can like draw up to 10 cards, but you don't want to use an attack for that. You want to use Colress for that. So, that's not exactly what you want. Then, next up, Minun. For one colorless, playful draw, you may discard a card from your hand. Draw cards until you have 5 in your hand. Also pretty bad. I mean, it's even worse than Plusle, draw-wise. So, yeah, no. Both are pretty... I mean, one is pretty decent, but the other one's just bad. Oricorio, the next one. Sparkling Pom-Poms. This attack does 30 damage to each Pokemon GX and Pokemon EX in play. Problem is, also deals damage to yours, so pretty bad. And second attack does for 70 for 3 energy, so let's just not even look at it. Next card is Mr. Mime GX. Ability Magic Evens. If this Pokemon would be damaged by an attack, prevent that attack damage done to this Pokemon if that damage is 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, 160, 180, 200, 220, 240, or 260. This is pretty interesting, I would say, because you can heal your Pokemon and then for it to even be a one shot, your opponent would have to deal a lot of like damage most of the time. So it's pretty decent, especially because this Pokemon has no weakness. So this is okay. Then first attack is, or like only attack aside from the GX attack, is gonna be for one Psychic and colorless. Count the number of cards in your opponent's hand, put that many damage counters on your opponent's active Pokemon. I can see that being pretty okay against the Rock decks, but then again... I mean, of course, it's pretty decent against the Rock, especially because without Choice Band, the Rock always deals even damage. But then the problem is, with a full bench and Choice Band, it deals 150, which is exactly a KO, so you would have to play stuff like Fighting Fury Belt, but then they also have Field Blower if they have a big... Big hand, but yeah. I mean, I think the card is at least it's a fun card. It's a fun card. And GX attack is one colorless, Life Trick GX, deal all damage from this Pokemon. fitting attack for this Pokemon, but nothing too spectacular. So next up we have Galpin for one colorless. Yawn, your opponent's Pokemon is now asleep. And for one psychic, spit poison, your opponent's extra Pokemon are poisoned. Random basic. Swallowed, stage 1. Phone colorless, amnesia. For the damage to your opponent's Pokemon attack, this Pokemon can't use that attack during your next turn. During your opponent's next turn. And for one psychic and two colorless, swallow up. For the damage, before doing damage, your opponent's extra Pokemon has fewer remaining HP, then this Pokemon does take this 80 more damage. I mean, that's not gonna happen because it has 120, so it's way too situation. And the first attack also isn't good because your opponent can just switch out and stuff. So, yeah, another bad card. Spoink, basic Pokemon, Bounce, which is Pokemon one of bench Pokemon, classic basic attack. And one colorless, Mirror Steps for Grumpig. 10 damage. If any of your opponent's Pokemon play have the same name of your opponent's Pokemon play, just take the same amount of damage. Yeah, now let's just move on.